Are we recording? Are we recording? We are recording. It says 30 in the corner, but it's going to be frozen for at least 5 seconds, which is probably over now. So we're going to start. Okay. Alright guys, welcome back to the Orc Build, and in this video, I'm going to be talking about one thing, and then I'm going to be building one thing. So the first thing I'm going to talk about is, this build is shit. I'm not enjoying it. No, I'm kind of enjoying it. It's different, it's very different, but the problem is that because it's so different, I just have my heater down, Jesus Christ, it's too hot. Because it's so different, it is dull. All the conventions that I've developed over, 3 years of building on Minecraft, for the kind of medieval style, but also lots of adaptations of the medieval style, all those conventions have been completely thrown out the window for this build, and what it's left us with is a very bitty, incomplete, unmodular, nasty kind of scraggly design where sure you have a nice building design, but there's nothing you can do with it. You can build that exact building design and there's no room for adaptation, there's no room for expansion, and it's just all a bit shit. So what I'm gonna be doing in this video is I'm gonna be building a big orc hall, and then I might leave the series here. If I get any more inspiration, I'll do some more series, but basically don't be pissed off if I don't do another orc build, because it's just not good. And if, of course, if I come up with another idea for how I want the orcs to look, another kind of another design, another outlook on the... Oh my god, there's a fuck off big black fly. What the fuck? How did you get in here? How the fuck? Oh my god. Oh, it's typing shit on the screen. Oh. Okay, right, let's just start building. Okay, I don't want it to be too big, but I want it to be kind of big. I don't even know what I want to build this video. Let's put it over here. This looks like a nice area. It's a bit like kind of bitty, the floor, but it's kind of a natural square. It could look okay. Okay, right, so the idea for this building is I want it to be kind of like a tent, but I want it to be like a deliberate tent. I want it to be a tent that has been put up for a for a long time. This tent isn't moving anywhere. And to start off with, I think I'm going to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 plonk. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 plonk. Let's go for 2 blocks up. Maybe curve it off at the top. So 2 blocks, 1 block. One block. How's that for shape? Not a bad shape. Not particularly orcish, but we can of course carry these on a little bit out the top, and that might look a little bit more orky. Yeah, it's a bit more orky, isn't it? Now this pillar up the middle, we can cross this block off and I'm trying to look at this through squinted eyes, but I must admit I've had a little to drink and it's all looking a bit blurry. I kind of like this chevron shape. A little bit? Maybe? Yes, no, maybe? Yeah, a little bit. Okay, so I'm going to go for an archway kind of entrance. Sort of like that. You've got two entrances on each side. A little bit Nordic. I've got to admit that it's a little bit Nordic, but hopefully the kind of inclusion of some sticky outy bits should make that all look not so Nordic-y. I was going to do that, but that's super Nordic. No, actually, that's not. That's cool. Oh, that's cool. Oh, that's cool, bruh. Okay. This is a much better start than I thought it was going to be. Okay, so the bottom, of course, is going to be cobblestone. Let's just grab a cobblestone block. If you're going to think about buying a mouse, don't buy a Razer Naga if you plan on using the middle mouse button a lot. Because I use the middle mouse button a lot. I use it for everything. I use it for StarCraft to move around the map. I use it for web browser. I middle click on every link I see on YouTube. I don't right click and then open a new tab. I middle mouse click. And it just dies. Oh, Jesus Christ. Both Razer Nagas have had two, and they both had the same problem. So If you do use it a lot, I do not recommend buying this mouse because it's not coincidence if it's happened on two mice. It's ridiculous. Shit. Stupid. That's what you get for buying overpriced pieces of munch bag bollocks from Razer. Although the Razer Switchblade does look really cool and I really want it.
Really badly.
Okay. Do I have single player commands on? Shit, do I? I do! Oh, that's great. Okay, brilliant. In that case, I can take this wall here and just copy paste along a little bit, and that will make my life so much easier. So if I take that and then I go copy it and I go 1, 2, 3. No, that's 2. Okay. Yeah, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. How's that for length? Seems legit. Okay, cool. So obviously this back wall is going to be fine, but we need to remove quite a lot of stuff from the inside of here. I'd like to keep that cross beam, but we can definitely get rid of all of that. So let's go ahead and remove ça. Voila. Now, I remember a while ago I talked about the amount of Russians I've been seeing in games recently, and I've got added to that list. I was playing Battlefield 3 the other day. I got back into Battlefield a little bit. It's, I love Battlefield 3. It's one of my favourite games. And there's so many Russians! It's ridiculous! Like, I don't understand where they've all come from. They suddenly got, like... I don't understand. Has the Russian government been giving out computers all of a sudden? They've all just appeared out of nowhere. I'm not saying there's anything wrong with that, apart from the fact that they tend to tease me. Dota? Horrible. I played a Dota game recently with some people and I was so bad. Oh my god, I'm so bad with Dota. I need to play... Thing is with Dota, I think you need to play a huge amount to actually be good at that game. And it's not that I don't have the time, because I really do have the time. It's just that I don't have the motivation. And I really should try, because I really want to be good at Dota, but oh man, I just can't be asked. It's far too much work. Anyway, what I'm trying to do right now is make it look like this is kind of sagging in between, and I don't want to. I think at the moment I'm going a little bit too far with the sag, but I'm going to carry on with what I'm doing just to see how it looks. Let's just make these two bottom bits. There we go. I think if I add another level to each of them, no, that ruins the effect. This should definitely be red at the bottom. Yeah, I'm just gonna carry on with this. Oh my god, I keep getting this thing. When people send a message on Skype, you know the little thing comes up in the bottom right hand corner. Recently, I don't know why, it's been starting to lag out my computer. And it's never happened before, but I was playing World of Warcraft earlier. I've been playing a lot of stuff recently. I was playing World of Warcraft earlier, and every time it popped up, I went down to like 20 FPS. It was awful. Horrible stuff. Reminds me of when I used to play on my laptop. There's a fun story. It's not a fun story, but it's a story. I used to play World of Warcraft on my laptop all the time. That was the kind of game I played. I just played all day. And I'd do it with actually every game that I played. It wasn't just World of Warcraft, but I'd play on my laptop and I'd play on my bed. Like, I'd be lying in bed and usually wearing like a dressing gown or something. And I used to do that all day. I used to play as much computer as I do now. Except I'd be in my bed all day. I don't know how I did it. You know when you look back at the things in your life and you're like, why did I do that? No, I don't understand how I managed to sit still in my bed all day doing that. Oh god, it must have been awful. I must have just, why would you do that to yourself? Yeah, it's a fun revelation I had. Let's just pop off this. This must be really boring for you to watch, but it is kind of late and I don't have time to clip bits out of the video. Stop popping up on Skype and I'm putting myself in busy. That's it. You've done it now. Yeah, that's it. You asked for it, motherfucker. Bitch. Alright, I'll do the sides first. Let's try and think of a logical way of doing this as fast as possible. If I do the sides, then I do the middle, then each piece will be the same. That's kind of one of the meta games of building a Minecraft, I suppose. Like, what order do you place the blocks in? Because there's the choice of whether, do you go along like this, placing all the blocks, and then go along like that? Or do you place all the blocks in this section, then place all the blocks in this section, and then the blocks in this section? And it's kind of, there's kind of an art to it, because you've got to work out where how much time you're going to waste not placing blocks. Because you're trying to place blocks every second of every, kind of, all the time. That's the way to be most efficient, and never have a place where you're moving from placing blocks. I'm probably not making any sense right now, but yeah. Random musing about Minecraft. I think there's a metagame to just about every game. And when I say metagame, I mean a level of thinking that to achieve a goal that a noob would see. For example, a noob would go on to a game, let's say, StarCraft 2, and they'd say, oh, if this person builds this unit at this time and then moves it into this position on the map, then they're going to win the game. And they'd see it as just that. That's it. That's the deepest it's ever going to go. It's like, build that time, that's going to win. Whereas a metagame, in the metagame, you'd work out why. Why is that unit going to do that? Is it because it blocks that person from building this particular unit? Is it because it puts that person under pressure at this precise moment at a time? And I think that applies to just about every game, even Minecraft. Even building on Minecraft as a metagame. I think that's quite cool, trying to figure out those metagames. I'd like to imagine that because obviously I have this YouTube channel where pretty much all I do is building on Minecraft, I have a kind of insight into what that metagame is, and that's cool. I like to kind of think up these ideals, these kind of standards. I don't know what I'm talking about. Oh, God damn it, the mega mouse is so bad. It does work, I just have to press the button really hard. Quite frustrating. Okay, let's bring along like this. Should I block off this end? Yeah, I think I'll block off this end. I'll put some kind of nice window here or something. Need this step. Great. Have I been doing this whole thing at night? That's horrible. Let's turn that to the great. Now, I'm not sure if I agree with these bits at the top for all of these. I think I'll get rid of most of them. Not that one, obviously. And just pop them on top because they kind of look like spikes. Quite cool. I think that should be like that. Yeah. There we go. Fantastic. I'm actually kind of happy with how this is turning out so far. Let's just pop some stuff in the middle, sure. Right, so let's get rid of all of this crap here. Be gone. Foul dirt. And we will replace the dirt with stone, I think. I think stone will work nicely. Here's an example of the metagame I was talking about. Do you go along like this? This doesn't mean you get to place the most blocks, but you're also quite prone to make mistakes. Or, let's do half the room like this. Or, do you go along like this and do each line like that? Which one's better? Because on this one, I have to look from here to up there to place the next row. Is that a waste of time? Who knows? This way you tend to make less mistakes though, so. So many decisions, guys. Okay. That's alright now. It's quite nice. I think I'd quite like to have these beams still here. I think they just look quite nice. And maybe going along the top here. There we go. And maybe going all the way up, in fact. kind of actually makes sense to do that. Brilliant. Okay. In the middle, I'm thinking about having some kind of fireplace. Again, quite Nordic style, but you'll find that a lot of these styles do mix. And that's okay. Shouldn't hide from that. Right, so there's our fire. It's a bit odd with these here. But what we can do is take some, let's place some wood blocks and then place some wooden gates on top. And it should kind of look like a meat rack. There we go. And then from underneath that, we can hang up some meat. Doesn't look like meat, does it? Okay. Well, what if we do that? And now it does look like meat. Excellent. Brilliant. So that's cooking our meal on the fire. Brilliant. What else can we have? We need some weapon racks, of course. No good orc building is complete without weapon racks. Ooh, the big black fly is back. Fuck off, you dirty thing. Where did it come from? Wow. Now for these entrances, I'm thinking about doing this. Just make it look a little bit more defendable. Like maybe you put something in this gap. I don't know. I want it to be open. I definitely don't want to have doors in it, but yeah, I think that's better. That's great. Okay, now we need a throne. Do we need a throne? I don't think the orcs would have a throne. I'm gonna say no to that. Although I will build a big ass chair. Which is basically a throne, but shh. Let's take that. Now you full block as well. This fly is buzzing around my face. It is actually really fucking me off. I'm going to freaking swat the shit out of you when I finish recording. Okay, so we've got a big ass chair here, where maybe the warlord sits, and this is like, come here in front of the fire. Yes, this is where the one he kicks him into the fire, and the guy burns, and it's funny. On this side, let's have a table, and the table we made like this. It needs to be a really long table. Maybe this is where something important is made. No, let's just put a candle on it. Brilliant. Maybe put down a pressure plate. Two pressure plates. Okay, this is a book. This is an open book. What else can we have? Well, we need beds for the big guy to sit in. The big guy, the war chief. He lies in there with all of his wenches surrounding him. By wenches, I mean green prostitutes. And then maybe he has some guards sleeping over here, which have chests each. And he should have a chest too, because yeah, even warlords need chests. Okay, I think I'm going to finish off this build now because I'm knackered. It's past midnight and I need to record. I am recording. I need to render this and upload it, and it's going to take a while. I'm not going to be asleep for a while. Ah. Anyway, there you go. So this isn't me saying I'm never going to do anything on the Orc Build again, but this is probably me saying if I can think of something better to do, I'll probably do it, because the Orc Build is somewhat dull. It's not challenging me. It's not. Yeah, I mean, I've enjoyed exploring it, but it's pretty much done. I'm just going to grab these and pop these along here. Brilliant. Okay, so thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to rate the video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys next time.